This week on the Total Man Ministry broadcast with Bishop Wells.
If they lied on him, accused him, even today they're accusing Jesus. They're accusing him of getting a baby that they can't find. So if they did it to Jesus, what are they gonna do to you? So you just gotta make it up in your mind. It's not them that's the problem. It's what's going on in you. How are you going to deal with the challenges that confront your life? To bring the lost to Jesus for membership in his family, to develop them into Christ-like maturity, to equip them for Christ's ministry on earth, to improve their quality of life, to be a ministry to the total man. Bless you, my brothers and sisters. It is with the joy of Jesus that we come bringing you a simple message, but one that is still true, that in these trying times and challenging times in which we live, Jesus is the answer for you. We want to share with you a message that we preached some years ago, and it's simply entitled, Watch Your Devil. We take it from the 7th chapter of Romans. When Paul says these words, he says, I know that is within me dwelleth no good thing. For when I would to do good, evil is present with me. I find then a warring in my members. When I would to do good, evil is present. We want to talk to you today about watching your devil. So many times we're busy judging others, looking at the weaknesses in our brothers and in our sisters. But God is trying to tell us, watch your devil. Examine yourself. Come on, let's go into the sacred sanctuary as we will go into more detail as we talk about watch your devil.
Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. There is a name. There is a name. There is a name. There is a name. Wave your hands with us. We just want to encourage you today. There is a name.
There is a name. There is a name.
Softly singing.
There's healing in the name.
7:16. Now then, if I do that which I would not, I consent unto the law that it is good. Otherwise, when I do that which I know I ought not to do, I'll turn around and rationalize it to try to, you know, justify my wrong. Verse 17 says, now then, it is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. Get that. Sin that dwelleth. Now notice how that is. That's a continuation. It's constantly there. I don't care how saved you are. You got some sin in you. Verse 18, for I know, now listen to this. For I know that in me, that is, in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For to will is present with me, but how to perform that which is good, I find not. For the good that I would, I would. I don't do it. But the evil which I would not, that I do. I want to talk from this subject. Watch your devil. Yes, 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 yes. I heard a preacher behind me, I won't call no name. He said, you got one. We all got one. That's something to think about, because the church today is good at watching everybody else's devil. We're good at pointing out your shortcomings, pointing out what's wrong with this preacher. I would go to this church, but that preacher ain't right. I would go to this church, but them deacons over there, they ain't right. Well, I got news for you. The devil is everywhere. Are you in here today? Well, if you're here today, I want to tell you something in case you didn't know it. The devil is here. Because you're here. So I want to talk simply from the subject, watch your devil. Satan and demons are real. And they are active today like never before. You see it in women, you see it in men, we see it in our children. We see things happening in our society that we thought would never happen. While we were in Florida, a man was high off of crack cocaine. They can't figure it out. He gets buck naked, jumps in the lake, and gets attacked. Now he's 6'4", 240 pounds, but he gets attacked by an alligator. And they were trying to figure out why, how in the world, the police said, well, we don't know, but we know he was naked and no clothes, but we didn't have time to ask him, why are you naked and in a alligator infested lake? Now you go in, when you go down to the Florida, common sense tells you, you stay away from bodies of water, because them alligators are there. But to show you how the devil can get in your mind and warp your thinking, he will make you do things that you thought you would never do. He will make some of you good, save and sanctify. Tongue-talking folks say things that you never really intended to say. And you'll turn right around and question yourself and say, where did this come from? As much as I love the Lord, I love him, and I'm doing the best I can to live for him. But why are these crazy thoughts going through my mind? Here you have grown men molesting little girls. And then on top of that, molesting little boys. You try to figure it out in your mind. Why? What makes a man? The thing that's really, I've been wrestling with this for the last 60 years of my life. What would make a man look at another man and want to have an intimate relationship with a big old stick? Oh my. I can't even stand my own whiskers. When they start coming out, I rub my face and say, my God, how are you rubbing up against all of that? Well, look at 1 Thessalonians chapter 1 and verse number 7. It helps us. It says, for the mystery of iniquity. Iniquity is hidden sin. Otherwise, sin that's in your mind that people really can't see, such as jealousy, lust, envy, hate, wrath, iniquity, hidden sin. Paul says to the saints at Thessalonica, for the mystery of iniquity doeth already work. He who continue to hinder will continue to hinder until he be taken out of the way. What are you talking about, Paul? He's literally talking about Satan. He is saying Satan is going to continue to hinder. He's going to continue to work on your mind and mine. You will never get so saved that you are immune from the devil working on your mind. A lot of times we get caught up with personalities of people, but listen to the word, in-me. Think about that word. It's really enter me, in me. I expect those out there, if you're saved, to lie on you. You ought to expect that when you're saved. You ought to expect people to backbite you. Especially if your life has embraced Christ. If you have embraced the walk of Christ, Jesus helped you to understand that. He says, if they will do it to the green tree, if they'll do it to the green, what do you think they're going to do to the dry? Otherwise, Jesus, if they call him a wine bibber, a lover of sinners, if they lied on him, accused him, even today they're accusing Jesus. They're accusing him of getting a baby that they can't find. Oh, y'all don't hear me. They saying that he had one by Mary Magdalene. So if they did it to Jesus, what are they gonna do to you? So you just gotta make it up in your mind. It's not them that's the problem. It's what's going on in you. How are you going to deal with the challenges that confront your life? How are you going to deal with those on the outside that don't like you? And I don't care how good you live, you're going to have somebody out there that don't like you. Let me open your eyes. Y'all got family members, blood family members that don't like you. Does that mean I'm going to throw up my hands and walk away from God because somebody don't like the way I walk or like the way I talk or like the what you do in the church? Well, I would work in the church, but Sister Sally don't get along with me. Mother Crawfish don't like the way I dress. Some of y'all will backslide and walk away from the church because somebody talked about your clothes. The devil is a lie. Anytime God has rescued your life and changed you and made your life better, how many of you looking at me right now know that your life is better because you met Jesus? And you're doing better than you've ever done in your life. And you're going to allow somebody who is, I like the way the young folks say it, who is a hater, cause you to lose your joy and your testimony. Talk back to me, say the devil is a lie. But the mystery of iniquity, he says, it already works. Now you got to understand, these demons are real. And I want you to understand that they will attack you. But let's deal with them. Who are these demons? And from where do they come from? The devil, in his beginning, was not the devil. His name was not devil. His name was Lucifer. Lucifer was the anointed cherub. He was literally next to God. He was the anointed cherub. God had created Lucifer for being the angel of praise. I wish I had a Bible reader that would go to this mic and help me read the 28th chapter of the book of Ezekiel and begin about verse number 12 and just help me preach this message. Because sin did not begin in the Garden of Eden. Sin literally began in heaven. That's where it had its beginning. Do I have a reader? Ezekiel, well, come on and read if I got it.
Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying.
The Bible says, moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, read.
Son of man, take up a lamentation upon the king of Tyre.
Ezekiel, son of man, I want you to take up a lamentation. I want you to cry out against the king of Tyre. Read.
And say unto him.
And this is what I want you to tell him. You tell him these words. Read.
Thus saith the Lord God.
Thus saith the Lord God.
Thou sealest up the sum.
We're going to go to the bottom line. We're going to seal up the sum. Read.
Full of wisdom.
You number one angel. You angel. When I created you full of wisdom. Notice this angel was more gifted than all of the other angels. He was an angel of wisdom. Wisdom means you have the ability to apply what you know. There are a lot of people who have knowledge, but they lack wisdom. Otherwise, they will go to school and get knowledge from a book, but they lack the wisdom of applying the knowledge that they have. They can quote to you all kind of sayings and give you the words of philosophers and giants, but they don't have the ability to apply what they know. The old folks call them an educated fool. But then you got that one who has never been to college, but he has wisdom. That's why James says wisdom comes from God. And if you want wisdom, he said, ask of God, who gives it and abradeth it not. He will give it to you if you just ask him. That's one thing I love about Jesus. When you know Jesus, you might have been the biggest fool in the world, and he will thoroughly change your life. What he does, he changes your mind, he changes your heart, he changes the way you think and the way you approach life. He gives you different kind of values. And when he changes your values, he changes your judgment. And when he changes your judgment, can I preach? When he changes your judgment, he does something else. He places himself within you. It's called the Holy Ghost. He puts him, Holy Ghost, on the inside of you. And the Holy Ghost will help you make good decisions. That's why he says, in all thy ways, acknowledge him and he will. Read the Bible, daughter.
And perfect in beauty.
Not only did I give you wisdom, but I made you perfect. If you want to see the ultimate of beauty, then you look at Lucifer. Read the Bible.
Thou hast been in Eden, the garden of God.
Matter of fact, I allowed you to go into a earthly paradise that I created, which was called the Garden of Eden. Are y'all with me?
Yes.
Read the Bible.
Every precious stone was thy covering.
Instead of covering you with skin, I covered you with precious stones. I made you beautiful. Y'all talk about complexion. They have a beautiful olive complexion. Some of them they describe as red bone. Y'all ever heard of the red bone girl? Some are red bone. Some are ivory. Oh, y'all don't hear me. God gives us all kind of covering. But with Lucifer, he said, no, I'm not going to make you red bone. I'm not going to make you high yellow. I'm not going to make you white, and I'm not going to make you black. But I'm going to cover you with precious stone. Read the Bible.
The sardis.
I'm going to put the sardis on you.
Topaz.
Topaz.
And the diamond.
The diamond.
The pearl.
Whenever you move, you will twinkle. I don't care who looks at you. You will get their attention because I created you. I created you as the anointed cherub. Read the Bible.
The onyx.
The onyx.
And the jasper.
And the jasper.
The sapphire.
The sapphire.
The emerald.
The emerald.
And the carbuncle.
And the carbuncle.
And gold.
And gold.
The workmanship of thy tabrets.
Now stop as I move on the inside of you, because I'm making you the angel of praise. I pray today's message in some way was a blessing in your life. As the Apostle Peter said, we want to stir up your pure mind, not telling you anything that you don't know, but just sort of stirring up that in which God has already put in you. It's so important that we examine ourselves. It was the Apostle Paul that writes in 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. You begin at verse 22 and read it all the way down to the end as you get to the close. He goes on to say, if we examine ourselves, then we will not have to be examined of God. Many times we're so busy judging others, looking and glorifying the weaknesses in others, when in reality, we should watch our own weaknesses and our own shortcomings. Just in simple, watch your devil. I want to encourage you to buy this entire tape. It will bless you. It's so unique because all of us are somewhere in sacred scripture. But I promise you, you will find yourself and many of the battles and questions going on in your mind, you will find yourself in this 7th chapter of the book of Romans, from which we are talking about watching our own weaknesses. I encourage you, get the tape. It'll be a blessing to you. You might want to send it to a friend. You might want to send it to a loved one. Please do it. You can get the tape calling us at the number there that's on the screen, and our operators will respond to you. May God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. You go with God, and He will go with you.
Count on Malone Media Productions for all your professional video needs. Services include sports filming and editing, professional documentaries and presentations, promotional videos and infomercials, job fair and recruitment videos, video consultation and training, portrait videos for all your precious moments, church and business commercials, as well as four-camera wedding and event filming. Contact Cottrell Malone of Malone Media Productions for a free promotional DVD and quote.